Erythrocyte sedimentation rate is a value in complete blood count that we very commonly use to assess the severity of inflammation. But in fact, ESR do not reflect inflammation itself. It reflects the amount of proteins in our blood. To explain this, recall that there are a lot of red blood cells in the bloodstream, and normally they do not stick to each other. The thing that repels one red blood cell from another is negative charge on their surface. Because they have similar charges, they repel each other. But most proteins in our blood have positive charge due to the amino groups. And this positive charge on plasma proteins can diminish or even neutralize the negative charges on the surface of red blood cells. And now red blood cells are more prone to stick to each other. And eventually, this causes formation of a stack of red blood cells that resembles a stack of coins, a phenomenon called true formation. And in form of aggregates, red blood cells precipitate, and the rate of red blood cells precipitation we call ESR. So because it's proteins that force red blood cells precipitation, increase in proteins concentration can cause increase in ESR. So for example, in multiple myeloma, there is overproduction of monoclonal immunoglobulins. In pregnancy, for example, there is increase in fibrinogen concentration. In inflammation, there is increase in pro-inflammatory proteins as C-reactive protein, fibrinogen, and antibodies. In all these conditions, there is massive amount of positively charged proteins. And increase in positively charged proteins cause significant decrease in negative charge on red blood cell surface. And now red blood cells are more prone to stick to each other. This results in increase in rate of red blood cells aggregation, and thereby it will increase the rate of red blood cells sedimentation. As a result, ESR will increase. So, as a matter of fact, ESR just reflects the amount of proteins in our blood.